She wouldn't listen to me. She wouldn't even give me 5 minutes out of her day. Okay.
Wow.
And because of the COVID coming in, and I took a little bit of a different stance compared to the majority of the sheep. Yeah. And I told her, listen, be careful. We're not going to take this. We're not going to do that. Right. She went against my word. I only found out by accident. Yeah. And she took the thing, you know, without me knowing. And that nearly destroyed me, but I forgave her and I thought we could move on. But the unfortunate thing is, once she got those seeds of doubt by the other women at her work and society in general, the social media, you know, validation by men and other women and all this, But anyway, we learn through the painful times, yeah? And I've learned a lot. But I'll tell you, it can really
it'll make you stronger in the end, but definitely more aware.
Oh yeah,
definitely
100%.
More aware. All right,
it's so like a gamble.
I wouldn't be bitter towards women, but you know, I've dealt with too many guys that's really been ravaged by women, financially, that lost, like my brother, for instance. He lost half of his substance because he remained in a marriage that I told him, man, I don't think you should marry this woman. He stayed in a marriage like 13 years. So now she gets half of, you know, when he retires, she'll get half of his pension. She took his house, one of his houses, his car, ravaged the bank account, learned the hard way. Now he's falling back into that same paradigm. He's engaged. I said, what are you doing, man? Are you crazy?
Again,
are you really going to get married in the system again?
I would never. But see, I was lucky. I put my assets in trust, yeah? So
you was wise. I wouldn't call that luck. I would call that wisdom and intelligence.
Thank you. Yeah. And you know what the funny thing is? I have friends that I tell them, you know, Johnny, whatever their name, put your houses in trust. They don't listen to me, right? One of them, I told him numerous times, he put it in his name, and his ex-wife came back with the kids, moved in. A few years later, she took nearly all of it, right? Wow. And he was about to jump off and went the big bridge here to kill himself nearly. And
wow. I don't these friend people, shot himself in the head because of that.
I but why don't they listen?
Last year, he shot himself in the head because of a bad... The woman left him. She got with another man, and then she turned his daughter against him.
Yeah. So the man feels the lowest... Look, I can understand that now. Not before this breakup. I can understand the pain that blokes, you know what I mean? Luckily, I'm a stubborn bugger and I'm going to make myself better to show her, yeah? I had a business, a thriving business.
Hold on. That's an Australian term. Enlighten me on that. A stubborn bugger?
Like stubborn means you're, you know, you don't change your ways. Like, I want to and a bugger is not really a good word, but let's say stubborn, you know. But the problem is there's one rule for them and one rule for me and one rule for he. The system gives women that. My mate bought a new car, brand new car. He paid for it. He put it in his name and paid the insurance. His wife left him and took that car. And the police said, you don't go anywhere near that car. It's a custody dispute. And the courts are going to settle it. And they gave her the car, yeah? He paid for it. He bought insurance, and but anyway, I told him, put your house in a trust, and he goes, I don't understand that. I said, listen, learn. He didn't do it. He put it in his name, even though I told him, and then he's complaining later about, you know, people don't listen because they don't understand. They haven't
Yeah. They fight against the things that you actually try to bring them.
Yeah. Yeah. So, look, I won't be getting married again. I'm lucky. When my wife found out that the houses are in a trust, after that she used to say, I said, they're our houses, yeah? We're a family. They're our assets, yeah? Because we're a family now. We're married. We're going to be together for a long time, right? And after, she said, what's trust? I don't understand. And she must have told the women at work, and they must have said, oh, that's bad luck. You can't get none of that money. And then all of a sudden she says, when I say, let help, come to the house and we'll clean the garden. Oh, that's your house. That's your house. That's your one. That's your house.
I would have gotten rid of her then. Those was a warning. Those was a warning signs. I would have eliminated her then. I would have eliminated when she started to, because you lifted her up. She disappreciated that. She was sleeping on a mattress, right? You brought her from all of that and lifted her up, and she still wanted more and more and more and more.
Yeah.
But, and this is the thing that I tell every man, when we start to deal with women, we really have to ask ourselves, what am I going to get out of this equation that some other man hasn't already had? Because a woman is anticipating you in most cases, right? Because a man that's established already, he's usually not looking for a woman that has money and financially secure, right? Because that kind of woman in general is going to be a problem, because she's already has the mindset, you can't tell me what to do. I have my own money. So the easy way for us is to not to deal with those kind of women, right?
Yeah.
You want to deal with a woman based on her submission and her willingness to submit and, you know, be supportive, right? To support you of your field of endeavor. That's the kind of woman a man that's established wants. Not the kind of, well, I got this. And so when that woman started doing that, you should have eliminated it. You don't have children. Man, you had such a strong, position in that arrangement because you didn't have biological children by her. You see? She had no power over you. You should have eliminated her and sent their ass back over to Vietnam and live in a teepee. The only thing you should have sent her with what was a pup tent.
Once she got her residency in Australia. Yeah. Anyway, look, I should have, but in saying that, I took a chance. The women are such good actors. The first 2 years, I said, I can't believe how much I love this woman. But what I did fail to realize, that it's like a pendulum, you know, swings that way and then back the other way. Right. I've been with women long term, but I love this, my wife, the most. But because the pendulum swung so far to love, I didn't understand when it came back and made me angry or frustrated. Yeah. I've never been so frustrated and angry in my life. Yeah. Because I love her so much and they can make you so the opposite. Yeah. And, my business suffered, everything suffered because I was distracted trying to make my family comfortable, trying to make my family feel safe, trying to make my family welcome. And I lost myself in the process and she just flicked me off like a little flea. Yeah. Once I had, you know, I'm not good anymore. You know what I mean? She needs to go to a better guy or something more, or, you know, he's not providing enough. He's not buying any more help, you know? It's shocking.
What type of work does she do?
She, in Vietnam, was hairdressing. So when she came here, she was doing hairdressing with Vietnamese, but because she had to couldn't. And then I helped her. I used to drive her, take her to work, pick her up, bring her home, help her get a license, everything. And then she got a job at a warehouse doing like just warehouse work 5 days a week. And I said, stay home, don't work seven.
And yeah, the fact,
then she done the 1 week, she stayed home, and then she went back seven.
This is what I want to tell you, brother. Yeah. First of all, I wouldn't want to deal with a woman at work because I already work too much, right? If you're being productive and she works in your work, if you have children, then that means some third party is going to be rearing the children. And that's going to be a problem right there. Right? So first of all, a woman that's going to be with me is going to be a housewife. Otherwise, I don't need her because I don't need her for her financial support. Right. And so as men, we got to learn to set boundaries. Right. And so we need to make a list of all the things that we want in a mate and all the things that we don't want. And so if the things that we don't want outweigh the things that we want, then we're already going to make a bad decision, right? So, and this is what I would recommend in the future, because she's going to regret that. Because the grass is not greener on the other side, right? It's not. It's very simple for a man that's established, that's on his purpose, there's being productive to go out and get an attractive woman. Any city in the world we could find.